What's that we got?
Chorus heart rate monitor. Gotta be checking this heart rate. Way more accurate than wrist based, so yeah, just keep me in check. Important part not to overtrain. And so, you know, it's nice to have accurate data on how hard I'm working. So it's hot out, it's windy out. This will tell me if I need to slow down.
Yeah,
there's
still like
bunchy
here.
5'10 might be hard, dude.
Oh, yeah, I'm for the 2K.
This is gonna be so unbelievably unimpressive. Like high school kids can do this workout. That's the point though. We do lots of it. It smells like tea out here. It's actually quite pleasant.
It's too windy today.
Thank you.
run faster on this trip. Old school threshold rule is if you can speak a sentence while you're running. This is me proving that.
Then it's you're still within range.
No.
Also, if you outrun the one wheel, if you outrun it, that's also outside of threshold. This is a threshold wheel.
Yeah, that is a threshold wheel. That's a good, it's a good metric.
Yeah.
start flipping the testing with either of that record.
Thank you.
corner. I know there's some speed still in there.
Nice work, boys.
You guys ready?
Yeah.
You want to test Tony?
Give us someone to poke.
Yeah. How you feeling, Drew?
Good. Yeah. It's probably the most boring workout you'll ever watch, but you know, it's threshold.
This is what needs to be done, though.
Exactly. Yeah. It's not about these any one workouts. It's about doing, you know, hundreds of them, thousands of them over the course of months, years. So yeah, it's just some typical Wednesday for us. But
do you think
over halfway?
Do you think about the afternoon session at all, or is you kind of try to keep that out of your mind?
Not really. You definitely get used to it. The more you do, or at least in my experience, the more I've done of these, the easier they get. Like I used to think like, oh my gosh, I can't believe I have 10 by K in the afternoon. That used to be my huge workout. Now it's just kind of routine, and you just kind of click it. You know, we're not running that fast, so it's kind of, yeah, it's good.
I'm like 160.
It's much easier for me to hold the camera going in this direction.
Yeah.
Because I don't ride, I would have to ride goofy.
Yeah. Sorry. Great. Do you want to help them break? Thank you. able to see the heart rate go up when I go up the hill and then settle back in. It's fun to watch it do that.
Is there a target heart rate that you try to stay within when doing threshold? We're looking at it now.
Like, for something like this, probably around 170. But it's hot out today. It's windy. So it's kind of like, I don't know. Normally it's just, I can kind of feel it out. The fact that I'm talking to you is a good sign. I haven't bit off more than I can chew.
Good work. All right, Tony, we got it this time.
Who you want to try?
Make a test group.
Test group?
Make a test group.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, you got it wet first.
You can almost shake it when it's in my ear. There you go.
Did I get you? Oh, there we go.
There we go.
Come on.
Let's go.
Try it again. Yeah. Yeah, some, yeah, yeah. Some
kind of or something.
Yeah. Yes.
I think you're playing in your car. It's fine. Yeah.
Ding, ding, ding. One lap to go.
This hurt starts with a joke.
Yep.
I'm gonna try to split between you two from here. Got you comfortable.
Heart rate check.
This should be a heart rate monitor on me.
Yeah, on you.
How'd you guys find this place?
Historic.
This is where?
Right, that's it.
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of the old marathoners in Boulder train around here.
It's the fastest track in Boulder.
Yeah. It's a great place. They plow it during the winter. The tea factory loves when runners are out here. So it's like, it's great. It's a win-win all around. They're gonna get customers because they see this video. Boring, but necessary.
So what's on deck these next few hours before the afternoon session?
Legs up, some fuel, eating, a few meetings. That's about it. My wife and daughter are out of town, so I'm like especially bored right now. Like, I have no idea what to do with myself. All right, let's see.
It's the last time's the charm, is what we like to say.
Yeah, sorry, I took a
what is it?
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Not bad.
3-4.
Talk a little bit about the HRV data they track on the Chorus app. And did you take a look at it between workouts today?
Yeah, that's definitely the thing I look at probably the most. I do it every morning. It's a pretty good indicator of whether I'm run down or sick or anything like that. So if I have a super low HRV, there's almost always something wrong. It's normally like I have a cold or I'm just training too hard. And so it's really nice for me to be able to adjust after seeing that. Like if I had a low HRV and I wasn't sick, I would just slow paces down in workouts or do less. And so yeah, HRV was good this morning, so full steam ahead, I guess.
Five pace.
First rep of the second session, how's it feel?
Actually, it wasn't too bad. Yeah. That one normally sucks. So if it feels anything better than sucking, it's good.
Thank you.
about a tall glass of Tony.
Ready?
What?
What else do you have here?
Tony wants it.
Got it.
2.2,
baby.
We're there. That's what I like to see.
quick is easy, just the person to lead.
Yeah.
I'll test it.
So you think it's gonna be more of an 8 or 10 rep day?
No.
4 down.
I'm flirting with it. I'm hoping 10. Maybe to be perfect, I do 9. I don't know. We'll see. It's not bad so far, but we're not running fast. We're running 5-minute pace, so you know. We'll see as we go.
It's at altitude, so
yeah,
a little bit.
I mean, it converts to like 4 flat mile pace. Altitude, heat.
With the heat conversion.
Volume in the legs. I mean,
tracks a little bit uphill.
I can literally find 15 excuses to get the time down. So
you want to jog 100?
Just let me know. Yeah. I always get out hot.
You alright, boys?
I can't describe a better situation as a pro track athlete. Seriously.
That kid stared Tony dead in the eyes and said, go ahead, move out of the way.
Oh, yeah. beautiful. So you guys figured your shit out throughout the day.
Uh-oh. Yeah. This is gonna be interesting.
I think they told me to stay out when it's
done. I still wanna hit a kid.
Max, this might be Camp Horizon.
See any future Tin Men recruits out there?
Saw a few. Little kids have such great running form. It's crazy. Then you look at someone like me and you're like, what happened?
Yeah, you look at the 357 milers, a 17-year-old, like, what happened to that?
You mean every 17-year-old in high school
now?
Now. Say
1-2.
Say 1-1. One.
Okay, that's good.
To see what the reaction is.
Oh, that was a good one.
Oh, yeah.
Because they were mad at me. I was testing low this morning, the one time I tested.
So we're going to say 1-1 one, one is the...
Yeah, yeah.
I'll get
watch
the
it actually
reaction.
1-1. One, one.
Sorry, you're going to kind of...
No, it's okay.
1.
Whoa!
Whoa.
Wow. 1.5.
I have such a parrot brain now. I can see an accident from light years away. I'm like, Ella, you are gonna hit your head on the coffee table. I can see this happening.
But you said a parrot.
Guys, what was it?
1-1.
Actually?
Is 1-1 good?
Really well. That's like running 7 flat pace.
Joey, 1-1 good?
Huh?
1-1 good?
No, it's actually running way too slow.
There's some truth to that. I have a problem though. I like love Joey and Tony so much. I'd rather just run with them every workout.
There was a time, believe it or not, we dropped him at the threshold session. He got fit.
Jordan, I was so unbelievably bad at running the last like year and a half, up until like a month and a half ago.
So I came just in time.
I know. I would have been done.
we're gonna finish right there.
Drew, do you want to tell them?
I did.
Oh, okay.
They lied to us.
They're not happy.
You are a liar, Billy.
They are not happy.
We'll spend an eternity on this ship.
I know. Purgatory at
Name
best.
That movie. Name that movie.
Pirates of the Caribbean.
Roxy and I are on Pirates of the Caribbean time.
Pirates of the Caribbean is the best race day movie out there.
That was an accident. Yeah, first time there's going to be a 15, but you won't get any past that.
We got Tony to do 9.
Don't think it. was because I was a good teammate. I just don't want to lead anymore. So I got Tony and Joey for the last two. That'd be so bad.
But I'm not going to make it easy.
Doing 10 after all?
Yeah.
We're doing 10.
You always kind of give yourself a few outs, but you always do 10. I honestly can't remember the last time I did less than 10. I got a little extra nervous with the camera, huh?
Broomfield? Remember the Broomfield workout?
I actually don't.
Sorry, not
that's...
Broomfield, Frederick.
How many did I do?
Cancer Connor.
I did 9.
Almost pooped his pants.
I did 9 that day. I've been thinking about it ever since.
I don't.
Joey has been doing the full double threshold since the inception
since
of time.
October.
Joey is the best person to coach ever. He never gets injured. You can just throw 100 mile weeks at him and he thrives. Dream coach. I'm like the worst person to coach.
Talented, but can't figure it out. Oh yeah. 3 or 5 or 6.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Hey, wait, I swing.
Do it, the high five. Say you have to end every workout.
Nice work, boys.
I kicked. Yeah. I kicked. This doesn't count.
Oh, no, you're too high.
It's because I kicked.
Everything's trending in the right direction where we need it to be. I was just looking at my base fitness in the Coros app the last 6 months because we've kind of just come out of like a huge training block. I mean, everything's been pointing towards the Olympic trials, so this is kind of just another, you know, step in that direction. But yeah, everything looks good. I've had like a ton of training in the optimized zone, and that's what we want. And things are kind of starting to get into the maintenance slash peak zone, and that's obviously where we want to be because we have our most important race in 2 weeks. So yeah, things are moving along nicely, and yeah, I'm just super, super grateful that we got a great crew, and yeah, everything's going well.
How important is it to keep an eye on the Coros data throughout your build up to, you know, peak races like in Olympic trials?
Yeah, we always, you know, we train with a lot of effort, but it's so great when the data backs up how you're feeling. So when I'm, you know, feeling a little crusty, I can go to my app and say, oh, my heart rate was a little high on those reps, or, oh, you know, my HRV was low in the morning. So yeah, it's just great. I think Coros definitely is like, you know, keeps accountability for me because I can sometimes overdo things. So it's nice to be able to really just look at the data from a workout and say, okay, I didn't screw that up, or, oh, we were in the right zone. And so yeah, it's really important. And I feel like it's a great tool just to make sure that we're kind of, you know, steadily getting better throughout the year.